Hey guys, it's Lance at Max Sound Solutions, and today I'm going to talk about what the VP of Hardware Engineering announced yesterday about the new iPad Air that looks a lot like the iPad Pro, Laura Legros.
Another great feature we're bringing to iPad Air is USB-C. USB-C increases data transfer speeds up to 5 gigabits per second. That's a tenfold jump in performance over the previous Air. It provides a fast connection to a host of external devices, like cameras, drives, and external monitors up to 4K.
Now, this is the first time I've seen Apple actually put a number out there for transfer speeds with iPads. Usually you look on the website and they don't say. They say USB-C, but they don't really say what speeds you can expect to get with it. She said yesterday, publicly, up to 5 gigabits per second. Laura is the only person I've seen actually quote a speed for transfers. My guess is it's a lie. Now, I could be wrong because the A14 is a new chip and maybe they have fixed something as far as transfer speeds go with the A14 over the A12 and the A12Z. But I'm pretty sure that everybody with the 2019 and the 2020 iPad Pros are getting the same speeds. I'm not going to run out and buy an iPad Air to try it out, but I'd love to hear from you guys, anybody who has bought it, what transfer speeds you're getting. The easiest way to do it is connect an external SSD to the iPad Air. You'll be getting a charger cable with your iPad Air. That is not a data cable. That will do very slow transfers. You need to buy a USB-C data rated cable that supports up to 10 gigabits or 5 gigabits. The whole point is Apple lying here? Maybe she shouldn't have opened her mouth and said 5 gigabits?
5 gigabits per second.
It was in her script. They're reading it off the teleprompter. My guess is it's not going to get anywhere close to that. But maybe with the A14, maybe it will. And that'll be a big deal because so far we're seeing 2 gigabits at best. 250 megabytes is 2 gigabits. Anybody who gets a new iPad Air, I'd love to hear from you in the comments. Just let us know how long does it take to transfer 1 gig file on and off your iPad. In all my tests, it takes 3 seconds to transfer it on the iPad and 5 seconds to transfer it off the iPad. Now, that is an improvement with iPadOS 14. It used to take 10 seconds to get the 1 gig file off the iPad, but now it's 5 seconds, but that's only with an APFS formatted drive, not with XFAT. I think XFAT is 14 seconds still. That's how long it takes. Because I have videos on this showing that just because it has a USB-C connection, we're not getting the transfer speeds that we should, yet the internal drive on the iPad Pro is very fast. So it theoretically should be able to do 500-600 megabytes a second, but we're only seeing around 250 megabytes per second at its best. Please give me a thumbs up or a thumbs down, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon to get my future videos. I just wanted to make this quickly. I was a little shocked when they actually announced a speed
up to 5 gigabits per second.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.